Welcome to Russian state TV channel Russia One. As if Russia, not developed enough to beat a few crazy Cossacks, had TV before everyone else. Today's date is 22 October 1972. I am your host, Yevgeniev Kazimir Bayenkin Alexey Ustin Zakharovich. Today we have with us a very special guest. Great Admiral, General, Leader of the Revolution, Tsar, Duke of Estonia and Livonia, and Emperor and Autocrat of all of the Russias, Peter Alexeyevich the Great. Yes, hello, Mr. Zakharovich. I am indeed all you say. Do not get it wrong, my friend. My name is Peter Alexeyevich Romanov, and I was born 9 June 1672 to the Romanov house in Moscow, Russia. I am and will always be the greatest reformer in Russian history. In fact, today I saved the Russian people and made amends with our longtime enemy, the Swedes. But not before showing them the great, strong arm of the Russia. If you know what I mean. My, humor in Russia, as if. That sounds quite European. This sounds like an insult. We won't be having that. But why yes? Do not see the processes around you. In my reign, we've seen the transformation of the dirty serfdom kingdom to great Russia. Sorry about this, oh great Tsar. We shall not have this. Do tell us more of your recent peace agreement with the stinky Swedish people. Well, following my success all over Europe with the newly redone, re-equipped Russian army, we were able to stop the stinky fish from continuing their expansionism in the Baltics and move to push them back and cower in fear from big, strong Russian army. This is our only one of our great successes in the world. All hail the great Russian army under your command, Tsar. Now, how were you able to do this under such difficult conditions? It is very simple. Russia was behind for so long. It needed a quick way to rebuild our once weak forces. Immediately after my coronation as the Tsar, I worked to build an army conscripting peasants and noblemen to bring great success. I actually believe Russia to be better for this fact than some of the European rulers. Can you believe they'd let their people rule the country themselves? Disgusting. Only strong leaders such as I can create such powerful country. Marvelous leader! How all Russians love you, and not at all forcibly. The best leaders are those who rule by force. Indeed. Why? By force, Russia is able to be much better. Force is how great St. Petersburg was built. Force is how we push back the Ottomans. Force is how we defeated the Crimeans. Force is how we defeated the Swedes, the Poland, and many other greatly regarded forces of Europe. Force is how we push back the power of the church and develop this great nation. Force is how we cut the beards, build the carriages, and modernize great Mother Russia. My word, what a great leader! Speaking of the church, what is your relationship to the Great Orthodox Church of Russia? Well, I'm totally not an atheist or non-religious, that's for sure. I mean, who needs such a powerful church? You can make weapons out of their bronze instead, ha 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 ha. Even though I am Orthodox, as were almost all Russians, I must agree with you, oh great leader. Is that sarcasm? We don't want to be sent to St. Petersburg now, do we? Oh, blit! I mean, oh no! praise the great Tsar Peter. Tell us more about St. Petersburg.
Well, when I went on my great embassy trip around Europe, I saw the great cities of Amsterdam, London and others. And I was like, Igor, why does Russia not look like this? And there it was, St. Petersburg. Although I saw many great other things during my great embassy, like the astronomy, the sciences, music, arts, and many other things. However, most importantly, I saw how much better Europeans dress than Russians. Goodness, what a trip!
Wow, how wonderful, great Tsar! And finally, we turn to your family. How would you describe your relations with them?
I'm very much the leader of my family, so I believe in the discipline, just as all my subjects should. However, nothing too harsh. Banishment works fine. Other than that, most of my children did die, because while I did develop Russia, infant mortality isn't such a great metric here.
Oh no! Soldiers falling into the ocean? I hope I don't jump in and catch a UTI that I will die from not too long later.